Hi everyone, so in this video I'm going to do example 7.7 from the book Stochastic Modeling. I sent you already the PDF file with the solution to this problem. I'm going to show you how it works with all the details and more explanations. So this is this problem that involves a woman who every morning goes to work and every evening comes back home. She doesn't take her car, she just walks. So let's draw a little picture of that. So that's her house here, okay? And she goes to work every morning. Let's say that's where she works. And she comes back home every evening. Okay, we assume that independently every morning, every evening, it rains with probably P. So I'm going to write this here, rain with probability P. And we assume also I'm going to call Q equals 1 minus P. That's the probability that it doesn't rain. Okay, so the goal of the problem is to find the fraction of time in the long run the woman gets wet, okay? So mathematically, let's introduce the events, let's say Wn, which is the event that she gets wet. She gets wet on day n, okay? And the thing I forgot to mention is that she has umbrellas, but instead of keeping with her all the umbrellas, she's going to take an umbrella only if it rains. Okay, so if she needs an umbrella and she has one at her location, then she's going to take it. If she doesn't have any umbrella, that's when she gets wet. So we call Wn the event that she gets wet on day n, and the goal is to find the fraction of time she gets wet in the long run. So basically that's also the limiting probability of Wn when n goes to infinity. So the goal is to find the limit when n goes to infinity of the probability of the event Wn. So to solve this problem, the idea is, and again, that's not something I expect you to guess for an exam. If I had to give this type of problem at an exam, I would introduce a Markov chain. You know, I would tell you, consider some Markov chain that would help you to solve the problem. So the goal is to find this limit. The idea is to call xn. So the number of umbrellas let's say at home, but that can be at her office, okay, in the morning of day n, but that can be in the evening of day n. It doesn't really matter which location you choose and which part of the day you choose, morning or evening. Eventually you get some like a Markov chain that is different, but eventually you can compute the probability of Wn from xn and you should get the same result. So that's going to be xn, the number of umbrellas at home in the morning of day n. Okay, so now we need to find, I mean, you see that there is indeed a relationship between Wn and xn, in the sense that if xn is equal to zero or the total number of umbrellas, so I think total number of umbrellas here is written r, so let's say number of umbrellas is equal to r, okay? So if xn is equal to zero or r, that means all the umbrellas are in the same location and that's when she can get wet, okay? And this will happen with some positive probability. So basically you can compute the probability of Wn by conditioning on xn, and P of Wn is going to be zero given that xn is not equal to zero or r. But now we still need to look at basically the fraction of time xn is equal to zero or r. So first step is to find the transition probabilities of this Markov chain. Okay, and that's based on the fact that it runs with probability P or doesn't run with probability Q. So there are several cases. You have boundary conditions depending on the number of umbrellas at some location. Okay, if so, first we assume that X is going to be not in the boundary of the state space. So I didn't precise, but the state space, I should precise that first. The state space is basically number of umbrella atoms that can be anything from 0 to R. Okay, and so that can be anything from 0 to R, and it turns out that so for all X different from 0 or R, you can compute the probability that, you know, the Markov chain jumps from state X to, can go from X to X plus 1, X minus 1, or stay at X. So that's going to go from X to X minus 1 with some probability. Probability that you go from X to X plus 1 as another probability. We are going to deduce the probability that you stay in state X by just looking at 1 minus those two ones. So what should happen so that we lose one umbrella? So let's say that morning in day N you have X umbrellas here, and so that means you have R minus X at her office. In the morning of day N, you want this woman to bring an umbrella at home, at work, sorry, in the morning, so that you have one less here, but you don't want her to bring back one in the evening. So it means you need to have rain in the morning, so she's going to be forced to take an umbrella, but no rain in the evening, so she's going to leave this umbrella at home. So those two probabilities are P times Q. So PQ is the probability that indeed you go from, you lose one umbrella from one day to the other. Then at the opposite, how can you have one more umbrella? Well, that happens if it doesn't rain in the morning, so she's not going to take any umbrella, but then it rains in the evening, so she's going to bring one back. So that's now the probability QP. So again, you get PQ. And so this means that the probability that you stay in the same state, it's going to be, well, 1 minus the probability of one of those two events occur, so it's 1 minus 2pq. Okay, so that's the transition probabilities. That's only true when x is different from 0 or r. Now, you have some boundary conditions, so let's see that. If I'm going to rewrite here, it's not a board, so I'm just going to do this. So if you are in the case of x equals 0, so that means that you have 0 umbrella here and all the R umbrellas are at work. In this case, you can stay in state 0 or jump to state 1. So here the transition probabilities are going to be P0, 0 equals P0, 1 equals. So P0, 1, again, this happens if she brings back an umbrella home in the evening. So morning, regardless of the weather, she's not going to take any umbrella because she doesn't have any. So you need to have rain in the evening so that she brings one umbrella. So P01 is going to be P. At the opposite, P00 is 1 minus P, which is Q. Then we also need to look at what happens on the other boundary. So what is the probability of staying in state R? Or if you are in state R, what is the probability of losing one umbrella? I'm going to erase here again. Okay, and now we are, let's say we are in state R here, and then that means zero there. So in this case, so the only way she can lose an umbrella, okay, the day after, it's you need to have rain in the morning so that she brings one umbrella from home to work, but no rain in the evening so that she doesn't bring back the umbrella. So here you again have probability PQ, and then here you have just 1 minus PQ. So that gives you basically all your transition probabilities. From that, you can deduce, of course, the transition matrix by putting all those coefficients in R plus 1 by R plus 1 matrix. You have R plus 1 states, so that tells you that P is equal. So the transition matrix is going to be equal to The first term is P00, that's Q. Then the next one here, it's going to be probably of going from 0 to 1, that's P. Okay, then only zeros. Okay, I just draw the picture for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so 5 umbrellas. Then we know that for all x not on the boundary, so x different from 0 and r, you have those things means that you have the terms above the diagonal and below the diagonals are pq, but you have 1 minus 2pq on the diagonal. So pq here, 1 minus 2pq, pq, 0, 0, 0, and you keep going like that. Okay, pq, 1 minus 2pq, pq, 0, 0, 0, 0, pq, 1 minus 2pq, pq, 0. And I guess one more, 1, 2, 3, yeah, you have one more line like that. Pq, 1 minus 2pq, pq. And then you have an exception for the second row. Coming from the expression here, you need a 1 minus pq only on the diagonal and pq here below the diagonal and again zeros. So that's what your transition matrix would look like. So that's in the case where r equals 5. Okay, so you have a general expression for general r. So that's the first step that follows like the email I sent you a few days ago. To study a Markov chain, step one is always to find, you know, identify the state space, then find all the transition probabilities, and then you can put those transition probabilities in a matrix. So that was step one. So now you understand that this limiting probability is going to depend on the limiting probability of, you know, probably that xn is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So what we need to compute basically is the probability that xn equals k in general for all k when n goes to infinity. And so again, for that we need to solve the system pi p equals pi. Notice first that from this transition matrix, you can clearly see that from any state you can go to the next one or the previous one, but you can also stay in the same state. Okay, so all those coefficients along the diagonal, above diagonal, below diagonals are positive. So that means that because on the diagonal you are positive, that means that the period is one. Okay, you can stay in the same state. So pxx is equal to, is strictly positive for all x. So that means the Markov chain is aperiodic. Because you can go from any state to the next one or to the previous one, that means also that from any state you can go to any other state in a finite number of steps, so meaning that the process is also irreducible. So, and it's also finite, so we have all the nice conditions. I can write here that xn is finite, irreducible, aperiodic. Okay, and so those three things imply that that xn is a positive recurrent, and there exists a unique stationary distribution pi. And even better than that, aperiodicity is going to tell you that the probability that xn is equal to k indeed converges, the probability that xn is equal to x indeed converges to a value when n goes to infinity, and this value is just pi x. Okay, so to conclude, we still need to compute. So now next step is to solve pi p equals pi. Okay, and to do that, well, it turns out you can easily check, okay, that's in the book, you can easily check that the vector q with after only once is indeed an eigenvector. So if you look at q 1 1 times p, if you look at the expression of p that we found before, I'm going to try to put it here. So this means that you are looking at, so the first coordinate is going to be q times q plus 1 times pq, so that's a q square plus pq. Then the second term is going to be, well, this pq, like p here times q here, so pq plus 1 minus 2 pq, that's 1 times this number, then plus 1 times this coefficient, so again plus pq, and so on. And you can check also that, so all the numbers here are just equal to pq plus 1 minus 2 pq plus pq, so it's always 1, and the last one is just pq plus 1 minus pq, pq plus 1 minus pq. Okay, so we did our product. And so from that you see that you have a nice simplification. Clearly the pq plus 1 minus 2 pq plus pq, they just simplify to 1, okay, this disappears with that, this disappears with that. And the first term is just equal to, if you look carefully, you can put q in factor, so it's basically q times q plus p. And then only once. Okay? But p plus q is equal to 1, so you get q and then only once. So this tells you that the vector q with only once after is indeed a solution to this linear system that doesn't give you the stationary distortion, because the sum of the coordinates is not equal to 1, but that gives you the expression of 1 invariant measure, stationary measure. And so you just have to divide by the sum of the coefficients to get the stationary distortion. So this implies in particular that pi is equal to, well, this vector, but divided by the sum of the coordinates, which is q plus, you have r once, so it's q plus r. So you get q divided by q plus r, and then 1 divided by q plus r, and so on. Divided by q plus r. So, now that we have our stationary distortion, we can answer the question by doing some conditioning. So, you see that from the fact, so there is a unique stationary distortion, we found it, it's here, and aperiodicity tells you also, in addition to finite and irreducible, so aperiodicity is going to tell you that the probability that xn is equal to x is going to always converge to pi x. Okay, as n goes to infinity. Okay, be careful, that's not the truth, that's not always the case if the process is not aperiodic, but here we saw it's aperiodic because you can stay in each state, so p1 xx is equal to is strictly positive for all x. So we have this nice convergence, and from that we can deduce like what we wanted to do at the beginning, so find the limit when n goes to infinity of Wn. So for that, you just condition on the possible values of xn. So you observe that the probability that Wn, the probability of Wn, sorry, is going to be equal to, so you need a partition, so you just partition on all the possible values of xn. You have like that xn can be anything between 0 and r, so that's the sum, that's going to give you the sum for x equals 0 to r of the probability of even Wn, given that xn equals x, times the probability that xn equals x. Okay. Now you observe, like I said at the beginning, that whenever x is not equal to 0 or r, that means that the lady has some umbrellas at both locations, so she cannot get wet, because if it rains, she's going to take an umbrella. So those conditional probabilities can only be positive if x equals 0 or r. So I'm going to write this, that's the probability of Wn given that xn equals 0, times the probability that xn equals 0, plus the probability of Wn given that xn equals r, times the probability that xn equals r. And so those conditional probabilities are equal to what? Well, let's go back a little bit to the picture. So when, I'm going to rewrite that again maybe, when you have zero umbrella here and all r umbrellas there, then she gets wet if it rains in the morning. Okay, so that's with probability p. Okay, so this means that this first conditional probability is equal to p. This is p. The second conditional probability is obtained, so when you assume that there are all umbrellas here and no umbrellas there, so here that's going to be the other way around, kind of, so she cannot get wet in the morning, because she has all R umbrellas at home, and the only way she can get wet in the evening is if it rains in the evening and she didn't bring any umbrellas at work, which means that you need no rain either in the morning. So you need no rain in the morning and rain in the evening, so that indeed she gets wet in the evening. So that's with probability P times Q that this happens. So this probability, conditional probability here, is P times Q. So eventually you obtain that if you take the limit when n goes to infinity, so that goes to P times, well, we know that this thing converges to pi zero, okay, because the process is finite, irreducible, aperiodic, and plus pq times this probability converges to pi r. And so that's what you get. You replace by the expression we found, that just p times q over q plus r, and then plus this pq here times pi r, which is 1. Divided by q plus r, okay, and then clearly that simplifies and you obtain 2pq divided by q plus r, okay, 2pq divided by q plus r. So that's the final answer. So let me check the book if it's indeed, yeah, that's indeed the reasoning, and we indeed get this. So let me recenter this. Okay, so something interesting to notice is, of course, the fraction of time she gets wet is going to be decreasing with respect to R, which is the number of umbrellas. That means the more umbrellas she has, the less often she's going to get wet. That makes sense. You see that something interesting also is that the fraction of days she's going to get wet is related to, I want to call that the randomness of the weather. If she lives in a city where it's always sunny, like Phoenix, for instance, well, not today, apparently, but... So you have P very, like, basically P is zero, or P is very close to zero, it rains almost never, so this quantity is pretty small. At the opposite, if it rains all the time, she's going to keep bringing her umbrella, so she should not get wet very often. And indeed, if Q is, the probability of no rain, so if this probability is small, and so it's, it's small, meaning that it rains all the time, then P is large, but Q is small, and so this quantity is again small. So it seems that the fraction of time she's going to get wet is going to, of course, decrease with the number of umbrellas, but also, I want to say, increase with the randomness of the weather. So that means she's more likely to get wet if P and Q are away from 0 and 1. Okay, so that's kind of what you can conclude from this result. And that's it. So I see you for the next lecture. I guess that's the last video for today's lecture. I'm going to post that right now on YouTube and send you the link by emails. So good luck to everybody. Good luck to everybody. Stay safe at home. See you next week.